Hey, how you doing? It's Emilio here, and this video is brought to you by Moonlock, where we do cybersecurity software for humans. Before we do get into the video, please do remember to always click on that subscription button on the bell so you don't miss out on any of our videos. And at the end, if you like this video, give us also a thumbs up. So we're going to be talking about this concept called a sandbox, specifically for cybersecurity people. You, me, we love cybersecurity. We need to ensure that our networks are kept safe. And sometimes you need to be able to test things before they are run on production environments. So what is a sandbox? Well, essentially it's a testing ground. Think of kids playing in a sand pit. You have now a test bed environment to test things without impacting the live production environment. So you can use them for malware analysis, software testing, and security research. So if you want a spot to break things, to test things without it impacting your network, then that's where a sandbox is super, super helpful. Now, one of the more important things about using a sandbox environment is that it is completely disconnected and isolated from your primary network. A spot where you can safely test code, a spot where you can get an application and security test it in an environment where it doesn't impact your production environment. Because the last thing that you want to do is be running things on a live server or a live environment, and then it impacts people, it impacts staff in a company, for example. So being able to have an environment where it's completely isolated, cut off from the network, is key. So let's go through some of the basic steps on how to set up a sandbox. So if you've got your live production servers, maybe you've got some virtualization technology that is running, well then in your sandbox environment, you want to set up the same sort of environment, because ultimately you want to be able to run and execute cyber code, for example, or test malicious software in the sandbox environment. And if it comes out successful or if it breaks something, then you know that you can or cannot be running this in the production environment. So try to keep the two things exactly the same. One of the easiest ways to do this is to use virtualization technology, to actually go and build yourself a virtualization environment, which then you can easily isolate from the network by creating different sorts of virtual switches and VLANs to separate the rest of your network. One piece of technology that I love to use is a tool called VMware. VMware, of course, is one of the largest virtualization platforms out there. There's a lot of other ones. There's Citrix, there's Proxmox, there's Hyper-V. Another option, if you have a Windows computer, is to install, for example, VMware's workstation or VirtualBox. Essentially, what we're doing is we're removing, for example, the Windows operating system from a computer and then installing the ESXi operating system made by VMware. I can then go and build all of my environments, right? And then I can isolate that environment quite easily.
So once you've selected your virtualization software, whatever that may be, and you've installed it, here I'm logged into the one that I've selected, which is VMware's ESXi. This is the main portal where I've logged in, and I've got access on the left-hand side to virtual machines, to networking, etc. Now in my sandbox environment, I've already got a few virtual machines already built, including a domain controller. I've got some Linux servers as well as a Docker box. And these are used for the express purposes of testing and sandboxing, where I can now use these spots as a test bed to test my security software, any sort of code, before it is deployed into production. And the way that you can easily go and do this is once you've built your VMs, making sure that they are mimicking your real life environment, under the networking area of whatever virtualization platform you're using, is to go and create relevant networks, relevant virtual switches, relevant port groups using different VLANs, making sure that they're on different VLAN altogether from your production environment. This will create essentially what's called a bubble network, where you are putting your test sandbox network in a bubble that is completely isolated from the real life world. So then you can go to your heart's content and test code as much as you need to. Another way to be sure is, if you don't want to use VLANs, is to make sure that all of the VMs are running on different subnets. Essentially, you want to look at segregating your network as best as possible. What a lot of people fall into the trap of is creating a network that is flat. where you've got all of the devices on a flat network on the same VLAN and all accessible over the same subnet with relevant routes in between. So making sure that you've got proper segregation, closing off and isolating your sandbox is the best way forward. Then once that is all set up and configured, you build your virtual machines, you go and download any software that you need to be doing your testing, you want to do some cybersecurity research, you want to learn about penetration testing, around ethical hacking, whatever that may be, that is the best spot to do it, because now you will not have any form of impact against your live production environment.
So now with a bit of a better understanding of sandboxes, you're now equipped on how to build up an environment that is secure and isolated so you can run your cybersecurity coding. You can make sure that malicious software is secure before anything is deployed in a live production environment. Thanks so much for tuning in. Give us a thumbs up, a like if you did like this video, and do remember to always click on the subscription button and on the bell. We'll see you on the next video.